Recently, I've been reading a bunch of stuff about how early digital cameras are being reappraised for their image quality, of all things. And then I realized I actually had a Canon Powershot camera in my drawer. Here it is. This is the Canon Powershot SD780IS, or I believe in the US it was known as the Ixus 100. Let's see what this little red devil is capable of producing.
So this first example is what I'm talking about. To me, this picture has some film photography-like qualities, but I do believe that it's pretty light-dependent in good lighting. Then, of course, the sensor is going to shine. But then you could almost say that about every other camera. But it's true that in certain lighting conditions, the CCD sensor does impart a special quality to the image.
When this came out, I think it was one of the most compact digital cameras available at the time. And this sports a 12 megapixel CCD sensor. It's a tiny sensor. I think it's 1/2 of an inch. No, that doesn't sound right. 1/2.3 inches. So, tiny sensor, CCD sensor technology, which is another thing that's kind of being touted as giving different image quality compared to modern CMOS sensors.
But I do think that that so-called CCD magic is very much dependent on the light of the scene. Here we have some more indoor settings, and these images have been processed a little bit, but I did want to see what I could get out of the files coming out of this camera and sensor.
There's actually a hack for this range of cameras, many cameras from this era and before, called CHDK, I believe. And basically, this camera originally out of the box couldn't produce RAW files, but with this hack, I'm able to get RAW DNG format files out of it.
With this in mind, I went ahead and edited these DNG files in Affinity Photo. I did some shadow lift and some highlight recovery, as well as some tone shifting for highlights and shadows. You'll see actually that some images have a black border around them. That means that it's the full sensor readout. If you go back, you'll see that some images don't have the black border. That means that I cropped them and reframed them, just so that you know.
So thank you so much for watching today. I think that will do it for this video. If you'd like to see more videos about this camera, maybe showing the comparison of the straight out of camera JPEGs with the processed RAWs and how far you can push each file, just let me know in the comments. That's something that I'm definitely open to doing. Have a good one. Take care.